Yo, what's up? This is Patrick from Guy in a Cube. And in this video, I want to start talking about all those great functions that were released in Power BI. We're going to start with the index function. Stay tuned. If you find this for the very first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date from all the videos from both Adam and this guy. All right, Jeffrey Wang wrote some really good blog posts to talk about this. Chris Webb wrote an excellent blog post. If you haven't checked them out, I'll put links to both of those blog posts in the description below. We're gonna start here on Guy in a Cube with the index function. And I like the index function because the simplest of the three, I think. And somebody asked me a question about doing something and I was able to solve using the index function. And you'll see what it is when like we like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. I want you to head over to dax.guide and search for the index function and take a look at the definition. It says retrieves a row at an absolute position specified by the position parameter within the specified partition sorted by the specified order on the axis specified. Lots of specifying going on. This, you, that. In this video, we're gonna start with the first two parameters. We're gonna start with the position and the relation. And then we'll expand on that in subsequent videos. The scenario they came up with was, hey, I have a country and I have sales for each country. And what I'd like to do is, if I choose Australia from a slicer, then I wanna see, is its sales for a given year up or down compared to the other countries? So we're gonna add year as a slicer here. Let's make this a vertical list. And so it's gonna look just like this. So if I choose 2020, I wanna get the sales for Australia and divide it by each one of the sales for the other countries and see what that percentage is. So the position and the relation, they're what I need. So I can get the absolute value of it. I'm gonna create a measure. And we're gonna start really simple here. Let's just give this a generic name for now because we're gonna go somewhere with this. We're gonna go total sales to compare. And so we're gonna use this index. We're gonna say position one, and we're gonna say all selected for my countries. So what I wanna do is get whatever in the first position of this relation or table. So let's see what happens when I add that particular measure, total sales to compare to this table. Basically what's happening is this is sorted. Australia is in the first position. So this index is one base. And so it's gonna look at each one of the items in the list. If I say number one, it's gonna find number one and it's gonna return number one. If I say find number two, what is it gonna return? In our case, it's gonna return Canada. So if I go over here and switch this to two, it returns Canada. And if I switch it to three and if I switch it to four, it's just gonna go down that list. If I change the sort order, if I add the parameter for the sort order and say descending, it'll do it in the opposite order. Now, I was thinking, and they were like, well, I wanna choose something that filters the table and gives me just the sales for that country. So it's like, use a what if parameter and go 1 through 7. So I'm gonna go here to modeling and then I'm gonna choose new parameter, a numeric range parameter. We're gonna name this country position. The minimum is gonna be 1. The maximum is gonna be 7. We're gonna increment by 1 and we don't need a default and we're not gonna add it a slice to this page. Now we'll create this and we'll manually add this. We're gonna go over here, I'm gonna add this slicer and add my country position to it and make it a list, a vertical list. So you can see 1 through 7. Then I'm gonna head back to my total sales to compare and I'm gonna add a variable here, say variable position equals, and then I'm gonna choose the country position measure that's created when you create that what if parameter. I'm gonna return this and I'm gonna replace that hard coded value with position. I'm gonna click check. And so now if I choose 1, if I choose 2, if I choose 3, notice how it's dynamically changing. This is great. But I was talking to Adam about this and he's like, do you really think people are gonna remember numbers or associate numbers with each one of those items? And I was like, well, it works, dude. He's like, nobody's gonna use that. Why can't we have a slicer with the country names in it so it's easier for them to select what they're trying to compare? And I thought about it for a little bit. I talked to Phil, but I was hoping Phil had something different. And he's like, disconnect the table. I was like, disconnect the table. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a new table. So we're gonna go to modeling and do new table and call this countries equals all. We're gonna put the country from the sales territory table. And I already created this rank and this rank is actually numbering each one of my rows. And so I created this before I started the video, and it's pretty simple. It's just a rank X, it's a calculated column over sales territory, and then it's based in the rank alphabetical order over each country. So the first country is Australia, so it'll rank one. So if I brought this over onto my report, you'll see Australia is one, Canada is two, France is three. So that's my index. Well, now, if you can create this upstream, there's an over function in T-SQL if you're using something like SQL Server, and you can use that to create like a row number. It'll help you identify that, and you should do this up on the source. But I'm using it here because it's just kind of consolidating the video. So now I have this. And so I use these two columns and I created this table. So let's go see what this table looks like. So this table is just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and the country. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go back over here and I'm gonna modify this code a little bit for my total to compare. I'm gonna say, if that country's table is filtered, give me the selected value for the position in that country's table. Otherwise, if it's not, just default to one. That's all I'm doing. And now I'm gonna modify this just a little bit. I'm gonna say calculate the total sales amount for that index for the country that I have selected. So it's kind of like a treat as, right? Or it's a filter that I'm placing on this table. Because I'm using both the rank and the country, I'm gonna need to modify this just a little bit to include in that table the country rank position, because I need both of those. So now get rid of this. And you can see, if I don't have anything selected, it defaults to one because that country's table is not filtered. But now if I go to my country's table, I grab the sale country, make a slicer out of it. If I choose Canada, notice how it changes to that. If I choose France, if I choose Germany, right, it's changing to the country that I have selected. Now this is a completely disconnected table, but it works and it's elegant. So now all I need to do is say new measure, and I go over here and I say compare PCT equals divide, so total sales amount divided by total sales to compare. Do that, change this to a percentage, and then we'll drag this onto the table. And then what you'll see is all the percentages. And so you should see 100% when I select that country. So you can see out the 100%. And as I move down the list, you can see that 100% will be equal to the selected row. You can go as far as adding some conditional formatting to add some little icons to go up and down and make changes. But with this index function, I could do things so easily if you just understand how they work. And we'll continue to go down the parameters. I want to start with those first two to make sure we have a good understanding of the foundation of this index function and of most of the functions. All right, what do you think? Do you have any questions? Do you have any comments? Are you using these functions? I'd love to know some interesting solutions that you're coming up with them. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If it's your first time visiting the IntoCube. If it's your first time visiting the IntoCube channel, hit the subscribe button. If you like my video, big thumbs up. As always, from Adam myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.